Alright guys, today I'm going to be showing you how to get better at Fortnite Battle Royale.
3, 2, 1, drop it!
No, but in all seriousness, I have had tons of people come into my streams and be like, yo, how are you ranked so good? How's your KD so high? How are you stabling your health? How are you always consistently at 100 to 200 health? And I'm going to be telling you most of my tips. Some of these are very viable in games. They do work 100%. I'm not going to be like, if I can do just, play the game right. No. All right, I'm going to be telling you 5 tips that will improve your Fortnite Battle Royale stats and just the amount of wins you get overall. Alright, but we're going to start it off with learn your building. I have seen so many people try and fight me. I'm slightly cocky here. I'm cocky, alright? But people that come up to me, try to build battle me and can't do shit. If you don't know how to gain that high ground in a battle, don't go for a build battle. Stay your distance, take some peak shots, do shit like that. If you can't fight someone in a build battle, you don't deserve to be in that battle. So maybe before you do your first game, go in and practice at Wailing Woods. And also try Builder Pro. You know, it really works. I don't care what you guys say. I'm actually better with Combat Pro. Just give it a shot, alright? I thought I was better with Combat Pro. I gave Builder Pro a shot and mate, holy shit, I love it, dude. It's so much better. It works almost 100% of the time. It works so much better. Just give it a week or so, practice at it, see how you get. I promise you guys, you will be able to get in a better build battle situation than just otherwise, you know? It's just having to tap R1 and L1 just to swap materials while building. It never works, guys, all right? Just listen to me. Number 2. Know your limits. Don't go in fighting someone if you know they have a rocket launcher. Don't go up close. Don't have a build battle if someone is shooting a rocket launcher. They're gonna shoot you down, all right? Don't be playing stupid. Play your game smart. If someone has an LMG, don't have a build battle. If someone has a sniper, don't stand still. Run in the open, jump every now and then, you know? Play the way that you see Ninja, Myth, Nick A30, Nick Mercs, all of that playing, alright? They don't run in the open just flat, you know? They jump, they do all this shit, they build. They don't rush by placing just stairs. They place walls under their stairs, you know? You guys gotta know your limits and what you can go for to get better at Fortnite. You're not gonna win games if you just push someone with a rocket launcher and all you have is, let's say, a sniper rifle. 99% of that time, you're not gonna win unless you're like fucking FaZe Clan, you can hit a no scope on their ass. But no, 99% of the time, you would not hit that. Don't push fights if you know what weapons they have, all right? You gotta understand. And also, don't push fights where you're not a good builder. Just stay back. If you're in squads, let your team do it. If you're not in squads, go in squads, all right? Number 3 is one that people always like, oh, dude, why are you always dropping Retail and Salty? It's because I know them back to back. I know every single house at Retail. I know every single house at Salty. Where the chests are, where the ammo boxes are, where everything is. If you drop Tilted and then let's say Greasy, Pleasant, Salty, all over the place, it's never going to work. You're not going to know where the chests are. You may be going to find one chest, and by the time you found that chest, someone else is going to be coming for that chest, and you're just going to be dead, you know, because you've wasted all that time looking for them. So just choose your spots, know where you're best at, know where you can get good materials. I know that when I drop Salty or Retail, that I can just run around, and there's thick trees, you know, thick, if you know what I mean, thick trees, and I get like 60 wood per one. It's just, I know my materials. I know what I'm going to get. If you guys are playing like you're dropping Bike Track, like what materials are you going to get at Bike Track? Come on, let's be honest. There's not many materials near Bike Track. So don't choose that spot. Choose one of the big spots with materials around. Good weapons. You know where everything is. Just choose a spot you are good at, all right? People normally complain about me always dropping the same spot, but I know them back to pack, and I'm just going to continue going there because I know them, all right? Number 4 is only if you want more kills, which I know most of you guys out there, because that's, most of you guys care about kills over wins, but there is some people out there that do care about wins. They'll literally camp in a bush just to get a win. But if you want to get more kills, improve your rotating, know where to rotate next. So if you drop Salty, you can rotate to maybe Retail. Don't rotate to Dusty Divot, because once you're in Dusty Divot, like, you're kind of stuck in there for a bit. Rotate to places that work for you, all right? And if you're at Tilted, you can rotate to Pleasant, to Greasy, even Soccer Field. And I know that's a small tip, but it really does work. That's why I'm dropping 15 bombs every now and then. It just works, all right? Know you're rotating, please. Number 5 is also one that I don't even follow. I know I'm a bit of a tard. But please just carry one type of med on you at all times. If you get shot down to 20 health, what are you going to do? Are you just going to sit there and try fight this dude? That's maybe, it could be 100, 200 health. You just carry one med. It could be mini shield. It could be big shield. It could be med kit. It could be bandages, slurp, anything you can find. Even if you have a campfire, you know, just please carry one med, all right? I do this quite a lot. I fail quite a lot on doing this, and it honestly leads to me dying. That's why I rage quite a lot in streams. You'd know. But anyways, guys, that's pretty much all my tips and tricks. If you do want to know more, honestly, this wasn't too in-depth, but it's just tips that I want you guys to follow, because I want to see you guys uploading some videos of you dropping 15 bombs, all right? 15 to 20 bombs. I want to see you guys doing that, all right? So if you drop a 15 bomb, tell me in the comment section, upload that shit. I'll drop a comment, a like, anything you want. All right, but in all seriousness, guys, I hope you guys did enjoy. Thank you so much for watching. If you do want another one, tell me. If you do want more tips and tricks videos, tell me, because honestly, I haven't really done these in a while. I'll probably do one every week, like, yeah, stuff like that. But anyways, guys, hope you guys did enjoy. Smash that like button, subscribe, share it with all your friends, share it to your trash friends, just so you can tell them how trash they actually are, because they're trash, let's be honest. Would put your lips on mine. I'm out, bitches. Catch you later. The aftertaste now. I'm a ghost. I call your name. You look right through me. You're the reason I'm alone and masturbate. Hey! I've been trying to fix my pride, but that shit's broken. That shit's broken. Lie! Lie, 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 and try to hide. That I'm at an all-time. No, 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 no.